Hello. I don't know what number vlog this is, 9 or 10, but today is May 14th. It is Mother's Day. This is another kind of later evening vlog. I meant to actually do this earlier today when the sun was still up, but that did not work out. I had kind of a busy day. I got up this morning and I went and picked up my mom and took her to my monthly photo club meeting. And we also brought along her little beagle dog that she just adopted from the SPCA a week ago. Hung out there for a couple of hours, and that was like kind of tiring because we were like outside in the sun and like having to keep up with the dog the whole time and just like talking to everybody. It was really fun and it was a really nice day, and it was like beautiful outside, but just kind of like a little physically draining. So then we went back to her house, and actually she like pulled out a bunch of Barbie clothes that she has. It was like showing it to me because she has all this like amazing Barbie clothes. And I have a lot of Barbies, but I don't have a lot of clothes, so she, like, gave me a bunch of it. And we just kind of, like, chilled for a little bit and, like, ate some food. And then, like, I was exhausted, and I came home, and I was actually going to walk to this playground not too far from where I live, and I was going to take some self-portraits. The playground is at, I think it's called Fox Elementary on Hanover, and it's the elementary school that like caught on fire last year, or the year before, whatever it was. And so the school hasn't been open for a while, and like normally you can go to the playground, but they're doing construction on the building now, so the playground was all locked up, like the gate was all locked up. And I walked around the entire block looking to see if there was, like, a way, like, a feasible way I could get in without just, like, hopping the fence, and there wasn't. So, I decided not to go somewhere else to take self-portraits because I really had some stuff in mind for that spot. So I just walked all the way back home and grabbed a couple of books and a blanket, and I went to lay on the lawn at the art museum and just, like, read. I also forgot that I had taken half a gummy before I went to do self-portraits, kind of on a whim. Like, I was like, oh, I'll go do this, and then, like, by the time I come back home, like, the gummies will probably have kicked in, and I kind of forgot that I did that. And so, like, I walked way back home and got my stuff, and then I went to the art museum. And, like, as I was kind of, like, getting to the art museum and starting to, like, set up my blanket and stuff, I was like, oh, I think I'm, like, a little bit high. So then that was just sort of the vibe at that point. And I just laid on my blanket in the grass for, I think, like, 2 full hours and read this really amazing novel that I've been reading. I can actually show it to you. It's right here. It's called The Death of Vivek OG. And anyway, that's what I'm reading. So I did that, and then I came home and I ate like a popsicle and I don't even remember what else, like a bunch of other stuff, a couple Del Mates, and then like I like baked salmon and asparagus and like made a salad. I just made this like beautiful dinner. And then I ate these like beautiful fresh strawberries from the farmer's market, like farm fresh strawberries, and some blackberries that I got at just like the store. Anyway, it was a vibe. That was my day. And then I was like laying here watching Queer Eye, and I was like, oh, I still have to do my video. So people ask me, as people ask everybody these days, like, if I smoke weed, and I feel like I don't, because I don't, and I guess now I kind of do, but, like, I don't necessarily, like to be high, or maybe I guess I should say that I don't like to be just, like, any high, I don't want to smoke just any weed. I don't want to do just any gummy. I would not consider myself a recreational weed smoker, like, at all. I got a medical marijuana card through the state of Virginia, to use marijuana to treat anxiety. I had a lot of anxiety the later half of last year, which I've had anxiety consistently and often since I was like 15 years old. But I was like in a cycle between like August and like early this year of just like constant anxiety, like every day. And like, I just like could not break out of it. And I tried so many different things. That was when I joined a gym. I quit drinking. And even now, like, I drink a little bit now, but like very, very little. Like, I'll have like a beer or two or a drink or two, like a couple of times a month. And pretty much just like socially. And I don't even always even like finish my drink, but I like quit drinking for the most part. And I joined a gym and I like did all these things. And one of the things that I tried was, I was like, okay, like I'll try THC and just see like what that does. And it has actually been very helpful. My anxiety did not come down until I actually quit drinking caffeinated coffee. I drink decaf coffee now, and that actually had a huge impact on like just like my daily anxiety levels. And so I did get some, so I got my medical marijuana card. I went to the like dispensary. I did get some flower that I just wanted to try a little bit. Like I got two pre-rolled joints that I don't are like long gone. And then I got a couple things of gummies, and I like cut them in half and I do like one at a time. And I basically just want to like take the edge off and maybe feel like a little bit high, but like barely. Like I want it to be something that I can like, I don't know. I mostly just want to like relax. I mostly just want to feel relaxed. And what I get from the dispensary and how I take it, like it's literally like exactly how I want to feel. It's like perfect for me. And so I don't, like if I'm hanging out with friends and they are smoking weed, like I don't participate in it. I don't want to smoke anybody else's weed. I don't want to do anybody else's gummies. Like I want to do like these particular strains of weed that I can like verify through the dispensary. Like this is what's in them. These are the like plant compounds that are in them. These are the like effects that these things have on a person. These are the strains that are good for anxiety. This is, you know, like I want to like know all that stuff and like pick and choose these like very specific products that make me feel a very specific way. So that's why I say like, I don't feel like I'm like a smoke weed, but I do use it medicinally. And now that my anxiety had like my baseline has come down a lot and I don't feel anxious like every day like I did before. It's less like it of an acute anxiety treatment for me, and like it does start to feel a little bit more recreational now, but I still don't want to feel like really high. I just want to be like mellow. Anyway, that's 9 minutes on my relationship with marijuana. I don't know. I feel glad that I found a formula that works for me, because when I used to smoke weed when I was younger, and then I didn't for a really long time. And then like late last year, when I started thinking about trying it again, I just tried some stuff that my friends had, you know, and I've quickly realized that like, I don't really want to get high socially. I don't want to be out in public. I don't want to be around people. Like I just kind of want to be like either at home or somewhere very chill and private. And like, it took me a while to kind of figure out what worked for me and if it worked for me at all. And I'm glad that like I did. I didn't really intend to make this entire video about that, but I guess that's what I have to say today. I don't really have a whole lot else to say, so that's cool. I'm at 10 minutes. I'm going to get ready to go to bed because I'm freaking exhausted, and surf's up.